We're celebrating history here right in Hudson. We're excited to have the event again, the St. Croix County Yellowstone Trail Heritage Day, coming up on Saturday, August 13th. I'm Michelle Stangler, the host of the Western Wisconsin Journal. I'm here with some dedicated volunteers of the event. So ladies, first introduce yourself and how many years you've been with the event.
I've been with the event since we started it in Hudson. I'm Linda White, and I helped put together the car show for the event.
Cool.
I'm Jackie Bradham, and I've, like Linda, I've been here since the beginning, I think. And I think we figured out that was about 2010 when we started this event.
So 10 years, over 10 years in the making. Gosh. Now the Yellowstone Trail, tell me about that.
Okay. Well, the Yellowstone Trail was the first transcontinental highway or auto trail that went across the upper tier of the United States. And it dates back to the early 1900s. 1912, I think, is when it started. There was a Yellowstone Trail Association, and they worked to promote better roads. They didn't actually build the roads themselves, but they promoted roads back in the early day before governments got involved and municipalities and cities, counties and states got involved in road buildings. Most roads were privately maintained and the Yellowstone Trail Association worked to get a good road from Plymouth Rock to Puget Sound. So they started in 1912, and I think it was North Dakota where they started, and they were aiming to get out to create a good road out to Yellowstone Trail or the Yellowstone National Park. So that's how it started, and it just kept growing and growing both directions, and it all eventually crossed the United States. And original roads, you didn't have roads that went from town to town. You'd take a bus, or not a bus, you'd take a train or by water or, I don't know, ox cart in the really old days. But you really didn't have a lot of roads, and a lot of times the roads got built around property lines. So a farmer might have a big field, and he'd build roads around it because they'd have the markers for the property markers. So people would drive from one property marker to the next, and that's kind of how some of the roads got started. The Yellowstone Trail Association just wanted to get better roads, so they promoted it. They kind of worked like the AAA that we know today, provided maps and information. And this was back before roads were even numbered. they barely went from city to city, but in early years they weren't numbered. And then Wisconsin, I think it was about 1918 when Wisconsin started numbering the roads, the highways, and within the state of Wisconsin, and that eventually was adopted across the United States.
Now we're celebrating a lot of history with this historic highway. How did the St. Croix County and Hudson get involved?
I believe that would have been through John and Alice Ridge. They are retired professors from university professors, and they live down in Altoona, and they got involved with the Yellowstone Trail, and they've kind of reformed the Yellowstone Trail Association. It used to exist back in 1912 to the 1930s, and they created the modern Yellowstone Trail Association, and it's basically car enthusiasts and people that want to remember the history of the trail, and they felt it was very important to just build awareness of this great road trail across the United States that people don't remember anymore. I mean, 1930, it only went to about the 1930s. So, they were instrumental in getting it started and promoting the awareness of the Yellowstone Trail. And they kind of went to community and were spreading the word about the trail. And Hudson took on this annual celebration, Yellowstone Trail Heritage Days.
So it's really, really important to the community. You know, there is so much to be involved in this event. And one way, Linda, are car shows. You're a car fanatic, I hear.
Yep.
Tell me about it.
We have a car show on Saturday the 13th. And it'll include vintage car shows, classic cars, British car show, and also Model A, Model T, Ford car show. So it's a combination of lots of different vehicles, so you can bring almost anything to the car show.
There's probably a lot of vehicles there.
Yeah, and it runs from 10 in the morning till 1 in the afternoon.
Okay,
so. And it'll be right down at Lakefront Park.
Yep, people have to come to that because there's a lot of history.
A lot to see.
A lot, I bet. You know, do you remember something from last year, like a specific car that really hit, like, oh my gosh, that was like the coolest vehicle?
I really like hearing people's backstories on their cars, like, you know, how they restored it and how they found it. Or sometimes these people find a car that long belonged to some relative.
Yeah.
And restore it. And I like that kind of stuff.
You know, what fascinates me more is just how you store it and how many years you store it for.
Yeah.
That's just crazy. Now, another highlight of this year's event is the authors of this book are coming. You mentioned their names before. Really exciting. What will that all entail?
Well, John and Alice Ridge, the experts on the Yellowstone Trail, they're coming and they're going to have their new book. This is a 400-page book, and it takes you all the way across, the mile by mile, all the way across the United States. I think Hudson is around page 250. And, you know, and it's full of little stories about things that happen on the trail, but it also gives you maps and mile by mile, like you come to this, how the old books used to be. They'd have written descriptions of how do you get to one place to another, not necessarily drawing. And, you know, it was like, well, go to so-and-so silo and turn left, you know. If you grew up in the country, you'll know what I'm talking about, those kind of directions. Anyway, John and Alice Ridge are coming to for the day. They're going to start the morning out. You'll have three opportunities to see them in the morning. They're going to be at the geocaching at Dick's Bar, and that starts around 9. And then from there, we're going to move them over to the Yellowstone Trail information booth underneath the Hudson Arch. So they'll be there for a while. And then the afternoon is the official book signing event, which is going to be at the Octagon House Museum up on 3rd Street. So if the reason to put them at the Hudson Arch is we're hoping that some of those car owners that can get a chance to get over and see them and talk to them and learn about the trail and hopefully if they want, get a signed copy of the book. So it'd be some amazing book.
Yeah.
It's more than 20 years of history. Yeah. And they put everything and anything in there.
I mean, a lot of great information.
A lot of information, a lot of pictures, a lot of maps. It's just great. You literally could take this book and start in Plymouth Rock and drive to Puget Sound if you had a month. I have no idea how long it would take to do that. And there are people that have done it. Mm-hmm. We had a few years back, we had someone that was walking the trail.
So oh my gosh.
All the way across the U.S.
That's a lot of time, a lot of effort.
Yeah.
Just like they put
a lot of shoes.
Now, what time will they be and where?
Oh, they're going to be at the Octagon House Museum, and let me see, that's from 1 to 4.
Cool.
When they'll be there for the official book signing.
So if you're wanting to see them, wanting to meet them, how more details about this book? That is when you're going to want to be there.
And you can ask them probably just about any question about the Yellowstone Trail, and if they don't know, they could get you that answer.
Yeah.
They really do. Have expertise about the trail.
And the car show before that, where will that be? Will that be in proximity to?
It'll be, right down at Lakefront Park. You come in like under the archway and the cars will be parked in the grass and we'll have our information booth will be right there on the edge of the archway.
The views will be just crazy nice. And another way to support our local community here is the poker event. Tell me more about what that is.
At our information booth, you'll be able to get a scorecard, and it's for the poker run, and a few of the spots are right here in Hudson. You'll be able to get your card stamped right at our information booth, at the Octagon House, at Dick's Bar and Grill, and then other towns that are involved with this event is Roberts and Baldwin and Hammond, and there's different locations in each of those towns so you can get your card stamped. And then it all ends at Sidetrack Bar and Saloon in Roberts, where you will get your cards, and then we have prizes, $100 for the best hand, and we also have a prize for the worst hand.
That would be
which
me.
Is $25. So you have a chance whether you're good or bad at poker.
Cool, and they can get that at the registration table.
Yep.
Yeah, and it's also in the newspaper insert. And
okay.
This insert, we got it into just about every newspaper in the county.
Awesome.
So whether it's the Baldwin Bulletin or the Tribune Press or Gateway News, you should be getting an insert either this week or next week. And
yeah.
It was this
Hudson
Star Observer. It was this week. Yeah.
Good way to socialize on a weekend, August 13th.
Mm-hmm. And this insert is packed full of historic information. So I recommend, even if you can't participate at Yellowstone Trail, keep your copy of this, because you can take this and drive the trail and read the mm-hmm. history articles about Hammond Roberts and learn and just explore the trail and have an adventure. And you can do that anytime. You don't have to do it. We'd love to see you on the Yellowstone Trail Heritage Days, but you can do it with that anytime you want.
I think it's so important to see the history of how the community has gotten to the point today, especially as we're nearing the end of summer. It's a great way to get outside, interact with family before it gets to fall, and colors are changing, but there are so many other pieces to what this event is. So what else is there that all includes it? I see that there's a pre-canvas party that's happening a few days before. What else are you seeing that the event all includes?
Well, the canvas party with Audrey Martin, those are fun. I think you've gone to a few of them.
I've done a lot of them.
You can get some artistic skills in there.
I think this year it's kind of lazy days of summer with a hammock painting, so that should be fun. And then we have St. Patrick's Catholic Church is going to have a pancake breakfast. I believe that's probably a fundraiser. Last year, I think it was for their youth group. Mm-hmm. And that starts at 7 to 10:30, so you can come down and have your pancake breakfast to start off the day.
It's a free will donation
as
well.
Free will donation for that one. And then at 9 o'clock, the geocaching group, we have an area geocaching group that is going to be doing a meet and greet, and then they do a CETO, I think it's called, a cat. Mm-hmm. Whatever.
But
you go to the parks and pick up trash.
Yeah.
Geocaching is just a great way to get outside to see and even pick up a prize as well.
Yeah, and they've added a whole bunch. We've been working with them with some historic caches that they're going to do. That there's a new game that they can play with the geocaching, so that'll be fun. And that can be done at any time. So the geocaching is, the intent is get you out on the trail. Then we have the libraries in Roberts, Hammond, and Baldwin will have history displays. So if you're on that poker run or you're just out for a sociability drive on the Yellowstone Trail, stop in at the libraries. But please check the hours that they're open, because some of them are only open in the morning.
Yeah.
And then a new thing this year is we're having a dance demonstration. That is, the Dance and Entertainment Studio will be putting on a demo of 1920s and 30s type dances. And that'll be in the Hudson Arch area, kind of down by the Boy Scout statue, I think, is where they're going to locate that. Next up is museum tours. The museum's open from 11 to 4, so if you want to come in and do a tour, you can do that. That's fun. And that one does charge an admission, and they recommend reservations, but
still, family fun event for all.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Family fun. And I think their theme this year is electricity, bringing electricity to Hudson, so that's kind of interesting. And let me see, we have hospitality centers. So if you're out and about having a day full of activities and traveling, you can stop at the Living Vine Church or at the Baldwin Public Library are two places where you can just stop, use the restrooms, relax for a little bit. The Living Vine Church is going to be having viewing or an airing of the Yellowstone Trail history video. So if you haven't seen that, John and Alice put it together many years, and it kind of explains how and why the original Yellowstone Trail was created, and it's very informational.
It is.
And it's really interesting, and that's airing, let me see, at 11, 12, and 1. So you can come into the church, cool off. I think we might have hot weather.
Yeah, the way things are going.
Cool off and watch a video. Watch the video and learn about. If you really want to know what Yellowstone Trail is all about, that's the place to go. I'd highly recommend you see it. And then libraries along the trail are just going to have one of the things we did is this book here, we donated, the Yellowstone Trail Committee donated a copy of this book to all the libraries that are on the trail. So we went out Woodville, Baldwin, Hammond, Roberts, and Hudson all have a book. The Hudson one's already checked out. We just delivered them a couple of days ago, and they'll get them into circulation. So if you really want to see this, you can get it at the local libraries.
So not only can you experience the Yellowstone Trail right there, but you can also learn about the history at libraries, museum, anything else.
400 pages.
Just a lot of ways to kind of interact with this historical highway that we have right here in Hudson.
Yep, it came into Hudson over the old toll bridge and the dike road, which still exists. The old dike road still exists. It's a really popular place in downtown Lakefront Park. But you'd come through Minnesota, and that was the place to stop. It was a logical place to cross the river. Before that, you had to take a ferry.
Yeah.
But Yellowstone Trail didn't come through Hudson, I think, until 1915, although the bridge was built in 1913. So there was a little time there. And then the trail, generally speaking, follows Highway 12, but over the years it had changed the route that it took because the businesses were vying. It was intended to be somewhat of a tourism initiative, so that you take the trail and the local businessmen would promote the trail, and the trail association would promote the local businesses. So over the years the routes have changed, but generally speaking, it follows Highway 12.
Yeah, so a lot of history in this event, but it would not be possible with all the events that's happening, all the people who made it possible. Mm-hmm. Who would you all like to make sure that their support gets recognized?
Yeah, we've got a lot of sponsors. Like many community organizations, events like this couldn't happen without the financial support of sponsors. And a couple that we'd like to mention in particular are our diamond sponsor, which is Jill and John Stina from Edward Jones. And then our platinum level is Fleet Farm. Gold level is the First State Bank and Trust, Gagnon Incorporated, and Quick Trip. So those are the top level ones, but there are many more at those lower levels. The other thing that makes this happen is not only financial support, but we also have a lot of partner organizations, like the Hudson Chamber helps us promote it. We've got the Minnesota MG Group, which puts on the Brit Fest, which is one of our car shows, and the Twin City Model A Club, Model A Ford Club, and the North Star Model T Clubs are joining us this year. So they help with the car shows. And then things like the libraries, they help us with the history displays, and some of them are poker runs. So there's other lots of individuals and organizations that help partner to make this event a success.
A lot of effort to planning it and to promoting it. But maybe this is a question for some of our viewers. Is it cost free? Is it mostly do you have to pay for anything?
For the most part, most of the car shows and activities, like riding the trail, playing the poker run, those are all free. There are a few things like the pancake breakfast. That's a free will donation. And then the museum tour, if you want to take a tour of the museum, that has a fee. But for the most part, most of it's free.
And being outside, it's free.
Yeah.
It's a good way to re-energize yourself for the next work day. Great way to celebrate on August 13th in the Hudson community here. Where can people find more information?
One of the best ways to find us is we don't have a website yet. We have the St. Croix Yellowstone Trail is on the, Facebook's. I got to make sure I get it right. It's St. Croix County Yellowstone Trail. So that'd be the place to look for us on Facebook, and we will have the event flyers on there so you can see all the events. Plus, we'll have all the Facebook events posts for each of the different activities. And then I'm going to skip to the next thing. The other place that you can look for us is to go to the Hudson Area Chamber of Commerce Tourism Bureau and at hudsonwi.org. And if you check on their calendar, you'll find Yellowstone Trail, and there's lots of information and details about the event there.
A lot of great things to celebrate here in the Hudson community. All right, last question. What is your favorite piece, favorite part to this event? Either the car show or the poker, you know, what's your favorite and your last plug to why people should come to this community event?
I have more
than
one favorite.
Yeah, I know. It's hard to choose. Linda, did you want to go first?
My favorite is the old cars. I've been involved with old cars for a long time, but I love seeing the old Model A's and Model T's because that's the kind of vehicles that drove the Yellowstone Trail.
Mm-hmm. Great answer.
Great answer. All right, Anna, I don't think I can top that. I think this year my favorite event's going to be John and Alice Ridge. I mean, this event wouldn't happen. It wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them. So getting to see them and to talk to them and learn about their book and learn about the Yellowstone Trail, that's going to be my favorite part this year.
Yeah, a lot of great things to celebrate the history, and we're going to make this event possible. Come on out on August 13th. It's the Yellowstone Trail Heritage Day, happening all day, the car show in the afternoon. Not going to want to miss out. Family fun, playing some poker, everything else in between. Make sure to check them out on Facebook for more information. I'm Michelle Stangler, the host of this segment on the Western Wisconsin Journal.